हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मिस पूजा अरुण मात्रे, लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन डिपार्टमेंट इन प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी भाईंदर ईस्ट। टुडेज टॉपिक इज CND चैप्टर नंबर 3 पार्ट 8। द लर्निंग कोर्स आउटकम्स आर मॉडेम्स, ब्रॉडबैंड मॉडेम, DSL, ADSL, HDSL एंड VDSL। मॉडेम, मॉडेम वर्ड कम फ्रॉम द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू वर्ड्स, मॉड्यूलेटर एंड डी मॉड्यूलेटर। मॉडेम वर्ड इज कम फ्रॉम द मॉड्यूलेटर एंड डी मॉड्यूलेटर। सो द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ मॉड्यूलेटर एंड डी मॉड्यूलेटर इज द मॉडेम। मॉडेम इज अ हार्डवेयर डिवाइस दैट एनेबल्स द कंप्यूटर टू ट्रांसमिट अ डेटा ओवर अ केबल और द सैटेलाइट कनेक्शंस। सो मॉडेम कन्वर्ट्स द सिग्नल्स बिटवीन द मॉड्यूलेटर एंड डी मॉड्यूलेटर वाइस वर्सा। द आउटगोइंग डिजिटल सिग्नल्स फ्रॉम अ कंप्यूटर मॉडेम कैन अ मॉड्यूलेट टू एन एनालॉग सिग्नल्स एंड इन द डी मॉड्यूलेशन द रिवर्स एनालॉग सिग्नल्स आर कन्वर्ट्स बैक इन टू द डिजिटल सिग्नल। द मॉडेम कैन बी क्लासीफाइड अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एज बिलो। रेंज, for the according to the range it is a short haul, voice grade and wide band. The modem as according to the range is classified into three types, that is short haul, voice grade and wide band. According to the line type, modem is classified into the dial up modem and lease modem and the private modem. According to the operation mode, it is classified into the half duplex, full duplex and simplex modem. According to the synchronization, it is classified as a asynchronous modem and synchronous modem. According to the modulation, it is classified into amplitude modulation, that is AM, frequency modulation, that is FM, and pulse modulation, that is PM. And according to the transmission media, it is classified as a radio, optical and dial-up modem. Broadband modem. A broadband modem is a type of computer modem used with a high-speed internet service. So the three common types of the broadband modems are cable, DSL, that is digital subscriber line, and the wireless. Cable, DSL and wireless. Traditional computers modems in contrast support a low speed dial-up internet, which is considered nearly obsolete in areas where the broadband service is available. So the types of broadband modems are wire broadband modem and wireless broadband modems. Wired broadband modem. A cable modem connects a home computer to residential cable lines for the purpose of the internet connectivity. The standard cable modem supports a version of the DOCSIS, that is data over cable service interface specification. See, in a contrast, a DSL modem connects to residential public telephone service for the internet connectivity. So both the cable and DSL modems enables the sending of digital data over physical lines. It is designed for the analog communication, that is the voice or the television signal. The fiber internet, for example, the use of the vision fires does not require the use of the modem because of the fiber optic cable supports all the digital communications. Second one is a wireless broadband modem. A wireless broadband device that connects to a 3G or the 4G cellular internet services are commonly called a mobile hotspot. It is not to be confused with the Wi-Fi hotspot. So technically speaking, you can use a smartphone as a wireless modem when you connect to the another local device in a tethering mode. It is a fixed wireless broadband service, sometimes require a modem for connecting the home network to the provider local radio equipment. This depends on the technology involved. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज DSL, दैट इज डिजिटल सब्सक्राइबर लाइन. डिजिटल सब्सक्राइबर लाइन DSL, इट इज ओरिजिनली डिजिटल सब्सक्राइबर लूप. इट इज अ कम्युनिकेशन मीडियम विच इज यूज टू ट्रांसफर अ इंटरनेट थ्रू द कॉपर वायर टेलीकम्युनिकेशन लाइन. अलॉन्ग विथ अ इंटरनेट, DSL इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर वेज ISPs प्रोवाइड ब्रॉडबैंड इंटरनेट एक्सेस. इट्स एम टू मेंटेन अ हाई स्पीड ऑफ द इंटरनेट बींग ट्रांसफर्ड. सो इट अलाउ यूजर अ हाई स्पीड डिजिटल कम्युनिकेशन ओवर द एग्जिस्टिंग लोकल लूप्स. इफ यू आस्क दैट हाउ वी गोइंग टू अचीव अ सम सच थिंग्स दैट इज बोथ टेलीफोन एंड इंटरनेट फैसिलिटी, देन द आंसर बाय द यूजिंग स्प्लिटर्स और DSL फिल्टर्स. So the DSL technology is actually a set of the technologies which is referred as XDSL, where the X can be A, V, H or S, that is ADSL, VDSL, HDSL and SDSL. The benefits of DSLs are no additional wiring, that means a DSL connection makes use of the your existing telephone wiring, so you can So you will not have to pay for expensive upgrades to your phone system. Second one is the cost effective. DSL internet is a very cost effective method and it's best for in connectivity. Third one is availability of the DSL modems by the service providers. Fourth one is users can use the both telephone line and internet at the same time. And it is because of the voice is transferred on other frequency and the digital signals are transferred on others. The fifth one is users can choose between the different connection speed and pricing from the various providers. Classification of DSL: asymmetric digital subscriber line, that is ADSL, hybrid rate digital subscriber line, that is HDSL, and very high bit rate digital subscriber line, that is VDSL. So the DSL technology is actually a set of number of technologies is referred as XDSL, where the X can be a A, that is asymmetric, H high bit rate, V very high bit rate. Asymmetric digital subscriber line ADSL. It is a type of broadband communication technology that transmits a digital data at a high bandwidth over the existing phone lines to home business. In order to access the ADSL, a digital subscriber modem is installed at a client side. The DSL modem sends the data bits over a local loop for the telephone network. And the local loop is a two-wire connection between the subscriber house and the end office of the telephone company. The data bits are accepted at the end office by the device called digital subscriber line access multiplexer. So the ADSL divides the bandwidth of the different pair cables of 1 MHz into the 3 bands. Here the diagram showing the asymmetric digital subscriber line. Features of ADSL. ADSL is one among the DSL family of technologies. ADSL is used in a local loop for the telephone network, that is the part of the telephone network that connects the customer premises with the end office of the telephone company. The telephone company uses a digital subscriber line access multiplexer and its end office so that the multiple ADSL users can be connected to the high-speed backbone network. The most common technology uses FDD. Here the two separate bands are used for the upstream and the downstream communication. ADSL uses the frequency bands, that is 26.0075 kHz to the 137.825 kHz for upstream communication and 138 to 1,100 4 kilohertz in downstream communication. The voice transmission occurs at a less time 4 kilohertz. So data transmission occurs simultaneously with voice transmission. ADSL filters are used on the customer premises with no DSL connection. High bit rate digital subscriber line. HDSL is a modulation technology similar to an asymmetric digital subscriber line that uses a group of the existing copper twisted subscriber telephone lines to transmit a data at T1 or the E1. The high bit rate HDSL subscriber line was the earliest version of the digital subscriber line. It is to be widely implemented. It is often used as a low cost alternative to dedicated T1 link for wide area networks and for the building to building communication in a campus wide network. HDSL can carry both voice and data over a single communication link. The maximum distance for the HDSL transmission is generally 3700 meters when the running over the unconditioned copper twisted pair wiring. Some vendors claim that their device support a twice this device distance. This maximum distance from the telco central office, that is CO, is sometimes called as a carrier service area, CSA. HDSL is typically used for the connecting bridges, routers, telephones, equipment such as a private branch exchange over a campus using the HDSL line drivers, which is built in a CSU by DSU, that is Channel Service Unit and Data Service Unit functionality. It can also be used for the private data network connections between the points of the presence and other services. It is not widely implemented at the customer premises level, which uses the more popular ADSL for providing the customers with high-speed internet access. Here the diagram showing the HDSL. Very high bit rate digital subscriber line. It is VDSL stands for the very high bit rate digital subscriber line. So it is a DSL standard that provides a high speed internet access. It is an improved version of the ADSL that offers the download speed up to the 52 Mbps and upload speed is 16 Mbps. Like provider DSL standards, VDSL operates over a copper wires and can be developed over existing telephone routing. This means an ISP can provide a VDSL internet access to the users as long as they have a landline and are located within a specific proximity required by the ISP. The connection is established through the VDSL modem with connectors to the computer or router one end, a telephone outlet on other. VDSL was developed to support the high bandwidth requirements of the HDTV, media streaming and VoIP connections by providing the downstream transmission rates of over 50 megabits per second. The VDSL has enough bandwidth to support all these connections simultaneously. This fast data transfer rate also allows VDSL to compare with cable internet providers, which have historically offered faster internet access speed. The first version of VDSL was approved in 2004 and is still commonly offered by the internet service provider. So, however, an updated version called VDSL2 was introduced in 2006 and offers symmetric download and upload speeds of 100 Mbps. The VDSL2 is typically provided to business and other organizations that require high-speed connections for the multiple systems. Thank you.